Hello everyone, myself Divyanshi from Gladwin Group. Gladwin Group of companies are engaged in the research and development and manufacturing of ultra-modern technological products like interactive flat panels, PTZ cameras, digital podiums, kiosks and many another products. Now, we are certified with BIS, ROHS and many other certifications and we are registered with MSME and NSIC status. And the most important point is we are the Indian-based company and our products are given 1 to 3 years warranty so that you can be insured after taking our products. Now, I brief you about this product which is known as interactive flat panel. Now, the size of this particular panel is 75 inches. Basically, these panels are available in 5 sizes starting from the 55 inches, then 65 inches, 75 inches, 86 inches and it goes till 98 inches. So these are the 5 sizes which are available in the interactive flat panels. Now the size you are seeing on this screen is your 75 inches panel and we measure the size diagonally, that is from this corner to that corner. Now if you talk about the configuration of this panel, it's having an Android version of 11.0 with 8 GB RAM and 128 GB storage. You can have two variants. You can have 4 GB RAM and 32 GB storage as well. So it depends upon you, like what you go for. So we are having two variants, 8 GB RAM also and 4 GB RAM also. So as you can see, I have zoomed in my camera. You can see the Android version is 11. The RAM is 8 GB and the storage is 128 GB. Now we'll proceed to further things in this panel. Now we are providing you several ports in this panel, like USB ports are available. If you want to connect external mouse, keyboard, pen drive or any other device. And if you want to connect your laptop, for that purpose HDMI ports are available. HDMI in and HDMI out, both ports are available in this panel. Now if we talk about if you want to give LAN connectivity, RJ45 port is also available. So many ports are available, you can use these ports as per your need and convenience. Now, you can see the features on this interactive flat panel. The first of the feature is whiteboard. Now you can see, here is my whiteboard. And if I want to use this whiteboard, I can use it very conveniently. I will brief about the features going one by one. First of all, you can see a pen over here. So you can write anything on this panel. And the latency is 3 milliseconds, which somewhere is negligible, right? So we can go, you can have different colors here and you can customize your own color also. From here, you can have your own color. Now, if you want different thickness of this script, you can have different thickness from the here and you can write anything on this panel. Like suppose if I have written Gladwin on this and I want to erase the content, so for the erasing part, you have to put your palm like this and you can erase like a duster. Now we are having undo and redo features as well. You can undo and you can redo. Now I am having pixel eraser. I can erase by pixel. Circle eraser is there. The part I will circle will be erased automatically. Now if I want to clear my whole screen at one time without wasting the time in erasing each and everything. So I can just swap this and my page will be cleared at one time only. Now, if I want to insert some shape, many shapes are available here. I have to select the shape and I have to drag like this. And I can have my shape on my whiteboard. Now, if I want to change the background of my whiteboard, now you can see different backgrounds here. If you don't want to use these backgrounds, you can customize your own background also by clicking on this addition sign. Now, there are two touches, single touch and multi-touch. In single touch, only one source can be used at a time, the second source will not work simultaneously. And there is one more feature in the single touch is that, like suppose if you have performed several steps in a single page and you don't want to switch to another page. So you can just scroll this and you can use the page to the maximum times. So suppose I have performed 3 of my steps on the single page and now I want 3 steps to be summarized again. So I zoom out the screen and I can have my 3 steps again on the single page. So this feature is available in the single touch. And what multi-touch means is you can access up to 10 touch points at a single point of time. Now if you want 2 or 3 students or people to come together and write on the board, So you can use multiple people and they can write simultaneously on the same board by using the multi-touch feature. Now if you want to add the pages, from here you can add the pages, and at one time you can add up to 50 pages. And if you want to have the preview of the pages, you can have a list from here. Now the most advanced feature of this whiteboard is we are having several mathematical tools integrated in the Android part only. So I'll click on the tools, you can see various tools are available here. Now suppose if I want to insert a scale on my whiteboard, so I click on the ruler and I can have a ruler over my whiteboard, and if I draw a line, the measurement will be shown automatically in this area. So there is no need to measure by your own, it will automatically measure the line and will give you the accurate measurement. So these were the basic tools which were present in the whiteboard, and you can split your whiteboard. What splitting means is, like suppose I have clicked on the multi-screen part, now it will ask me like in how many parts or how many divisions I want on my whiteboard. So if I click 3 and I select the background, now my screen has been splitted into the 3 parts. Now what this means is 3 people can use their individual whiteboards on the single screen. The person who is in this partition cannot go beyond this. So in the same manner, 3 persons can have their individual whiteboards on the same screen. So this was the feature for the multi-screen. Now if you want to share the content, whatever you have explained here, you want to share those things, you will click on the QR code. Now it will generate a QR code over here. Now the moment you will scan this QR code, the document will be into your phone in the form of the PDF. You can encrypt it also, it will generate a password. Now the people or the persons who are having this password, only they can generate this particular document or they can access this particular document. Now if you want to save the file, there is an option for the save. 3 formats are available. In whatever format you want to save, you can save your document and you can keep in the file manager for your future use. Now I clicked on the confirm. Now it will be saved in my file management and the notification is here. Now if I want to insert something, I click on the insert. I select my image and I can insert any of the image on my whiteboard. Whether it's downloaded, whether it's a screenshot, if there is any image, I can put it on my whiteboard. Suppose I have clicked on this picture, I click on the confirm. Now my picture is on the whiteboard. I can zoom in, I can zoom out, I can tilt, whatever I want to do, I can do with this image. And even if I want to write on it, I can write on it. So these were the basic features of the whiteboard. Now we'll come to the next of the features. Now I'm having a file manager here. Now what file manager means is, if I'm having several documents, if I'm having several files in my panel, so all the files will be reflected in the file manager only. So you can use the file manager for searching the files in the panel, for making the new folders and for renaming the folders. So you can use the file manager from here. Now next of the feature is VIP. It acts like a theme. If you want several themes on your panel, like if you want a theme related to clothing, so you click on the clothing, now you can see different themes are available, so you can use this themes as well. Now there is an option for the multi-screen. Now what multi-screen means is, like suppose if you are having some content in your phone or laptop and you want to show that content on the panel, so you can use this multi-screen feature, but there is one condition for this casting or mirroring purpose, is that the network should be safe. Okay, now at one point of time you can cast up to 4 devices. Divisions will be made on the screen and you can cast your iPhone, your MacBook, laptop, PC, anything you want to mirror, you can mirror on the screen. Like I show you, I'm having my phone, and what I'll do is, my Wi-Fi network is safe of the phone and the panel. Now I'll cast my phone on this panel by using this eShare application. Now I can show you the eShare application. This is my eShare application. As you can see my phone, now it will ask me for the sharing the screen. I'll share the screen. Now you can see the screen of my phone on this panel. Now I can do anything. If I'm doing anything on my phone, will be reflected on this panel. Now suppose if I want to show some PDF on this, so I can have my PDF on this screen. You can zoom in, you can zoom out. So you can cast the phone, you can cast your laptop, you can cast anything on this panel, whether it's an iPhone or anything you want to cast. So this was about the casting purpose. Now you can see multiple applications are available here. Now if you want to show some presentations or you want to make some presentations, so you can use the WPS Office. From WPS Office is a software which provides the path to PPTs, PDFs, Excel sheets to be opened on this panel. Now suppose if I want to use Whiteboard and WPS simultaneously on the same screen, so I'm having an option for the split screen. Now split screening will enable me to use two applications at the same time on the same screen. So here I can use my WPS, I can make the presentations, I can play the presentations, and here I can explain the same about the presentations. So even I can have my YouTube and my Whiteboard on the same screen. So in this way I can use two of my applications simultaneously on the same screen. Now we'll come to the another features. There is a Play Store is also available. If you want to install some application, you can use the Play Store. These are the applications which will be pre-installed in your panel. Now in spite of these applications, if you want to use your own software or you want to use your own application, so for that purpose you can use Play Store or Aptoide TV as well. Now you can see the YouTube also, you can play several videos. Two speakers are there, 15 watts each. You can use the speakers. The total output will be of 30 watts. Now I show a video over here and it supports 4K video. So I play a 4K video so that you can be clear with the clarity of this camera and panel as well. Now this is the sound. Two speakers are there. And from here, I can adjust my volume as per my need. And it supports 4K. I'll show that 4K configuration also. So I'll click over the 2160p, which means it supports 4K videos as well. So this is the clarity of the panel. So it supports 4K. It's having a resolution of 3840 into 2160p. Now some of the features are there, like you can record your screen, you can take the screenshots, you can adjust the brightness, you can adjust the volume as well. So from here you can adjust the brightness of your panel. In this way, if you want to use spotlight, if you want to concentrate on some particular area, so you can use the spotlight like this. So these were the basic features which were available in the panel. So this was Android part, and when you want this Android part to be converted into the Windows, then we attach a device which is known as the OPS. OPS is known as the operating system, and it's a device which will convert your Android system into the Windows, and that the configuration of the Windows you can customize as per your need. Whether you want to go with 4GB RAM or whether you want to go with 16GB RAM. So you can customize the configuration of the OPS as per your need. So these were the basic features of the interactive flat panel. And if you have any query or any doubts related to this interactive flat panel, you can post your comments. We'll try to answer each and every comment in a very appropriate way. Thank you so much.